What's going on, man? John Doe underscore 4 back in the building. You feel me? And the reason for me making this video today is to refer to the Nipsey Hussle passing away that took place recently. And as most of us, you feel me, we didn't really take this very well. And some of us are still in mourning and, you know, still shedding tears and whatnot, whatever the case may be. But I was in Vegas earlier today, and I was on my way back. And, you know, I listened to Nipsey Hussle prior to this. Like I've been rocking with him since 07, since the nigga first came out. And I heard that the Bullets, you feel me? I know that the Slawson Boy was one of his first little tapes he put together, but I've been rocking with him since Bullets Have No Names, Part 1. And since then, any young nigga that was in our generation or time frame, you feel me, niggas was on to him, you feel me? That was that nigga. I don't care if he was Blood, Crip, wherever the fuck he was from. That was the nigga that we was listening to, because after Dribble, when he first came out, I was like, oh, nah, that ain't it, you feel me, type of shit. You feel me? Like, nah, hell nah, that nigga too, you know what I mean? Because considering the fact I'm a Damo, you feel me, and he was not really saying too many Damo things, you feel me? But at the end of the day, you feel me, the more I listened to him, I was like, I don't give a fuck. Blood hard. You feel me? Blood dope. I don't give a fuck. One way or another, man, this nigga dope. And then, you know what I'm saying, I be in the hood with the homies, and these niggas be listening to him, too. I'm like, hey, that nigga be saying some shit. You know what I'm saying? It was already understood. You feel me? So, I say all that to say this. So, I can honestly say that's someone I'm a fan of, you feel me? I ain't no starstruck ass type nigga, but that was a nigga I would like to have gotten the chance to do music with. But at the end of the day, so I'm on the way back. You know, Vegas got that long ass little strip that we take on the way back home. And as I'm on the ride back home, I'm listening to music. You feel me? I had went through a couple of Nipsey songs already. And then, you feel me, I was like, man, let me hear some Pac too, man. Because, you know, Pac is timeless music. Shit never get old. So I went to Pac and I started playing Pac. But the song that had popped up, you feel me, because I had my shit on my shuffle. So the shit is going through random shit. So I heard Pac, like, oh, yeah, something to get a bar some Pac, right? So as I'm listening, the song that had came on was Only Fear of Death. And you know, that shit not, you feel me? But what had really caught me was when I got towards the end of the song, you know, the nigga says something like, you know, he's talking like a spiritual type voice, or, you know, like where people can say, like, you know, it's evil, whatever the fuck title you want to put on it. You hear the nigga say, you know, rest in peace to a couple individuals. And as I'm listening, I hear the nigga say R.I.P. Nipsey. That's what it sound like to me. I know recently you can't go on any type of social media or internet without hearing about the passing of this man. You feel me? So that would be like, okay, the first thing that popped in my head, like, oh, it's probably because I'm so bamboozled by hearing it so much. You feel me? It's to the point where it's like, okay, man, I can't really go anywhere or look at anything without hearing it. It's like it's so consistent and repetitive. But when I heard the song, I was like, this nigga ain't never just said R.I.P. Nipsey, right? So when I play it back, it still sounds the same to me. So I'm like, let me get another opinion. You feel me? So I'm in the car with my baby mama. You feel me? I let her hear the part. I'm like, what does this sound like to you? Because to me, it sounded like the nigga said R.I.P. Nipsey. Feel me? So I played for her, and she hear it. She's like, oh, my God. Whoa. Feel me? There's another individual in the vehicle. Feel me? She played it for her, and she hear it. She's like, oh, they just did that. I said, no, because I've had this song on here for quite some time, and this was something that never had really caught my attention. And on top of the fact, I have many songs I listen to, so I'm not just focusing on every Tupac song, trying to break them down bar for bar, this, that, and the other. But at the end of the day, it sounded a little too similar, if not exactly what I thought it was. So I was thinking, I'm like, what the fuck? So then I'm thinking, maybe a nigga probably just put a little too much on it. So I go look at the lyrics. But you know when you look up lyrics, they not really 100% accurate. Some things, it sound like some shit the person might have said, but then when you listen to the shit for real, that ain't what it said. That's not what the nigga said. You feel me? You could hear it clear as day in some songs, that's not what the nigga said. You feel me? So I'm like, yeah, blood. Some of these niggas, I don't know. You feel me? So my reason for saying that is, I looked it up and it said like some other shit. I couldn't tell you, cause I know what the man said. You understand me? Pac didn't say whatever the fuck it says on them lyrics. It don't say that. You feel me? And I went and looked up the song. You feel me? On YouTube, and there is I listened to the version that I had already downloaded, cause I downloaded the song off YouTube. Feel me? And the other versions of the song, because there are other, you know, other people upload other versions of songs. Some might be a little bit longer. Some might be a little bit shorter than the one that you may be used to hearing. So I listened to one of them, and it didn't sound like he said what I thought he said. Feel me? So now I'm like, hold on, what the fuck am I tripping? So then I go back to the one that I had originally downloaded. And the nigga says exactly what I think he said. And it's my nigga, if I'm wrong, my nigga, please let me know. Because I don't mind correction, nigga. I take correction. If I'm doing something wrong and you know the right way to do it, nigga, let me know. Nigga, what the fuck? Don't make me continue doing things out of order or whatever the case may be. Feel me? Please let me know, nigga. Feel free. I accept correction. I don't mind it. I actually embrace it, nigga. If I just did or say something wrong, let me know, my nigga. Please, by any means, I take it and I accept it. You feel me? Cause if I'm doing something the wrong way and you know the right way, nigga, shit, why you ain't let me know? You feel me? Then again, it could be a personal opinion. Shit, you have your opinion, I have mine. But this is what I have came across today, and this is what I'm going with, nigga. This nigga Pac said, "R.P. Nipsey, blood." And the reason why I'm saying that is because you got to look at it more so on a spiritual level. You feel me? Different spirits come in and out of your body. You feel me? Some people may be in a different spirit living through them. You feel me? Like even before Pac. Like Pac could or may, or from my understanding, he had the spirit of Malcolm X. Just because they didn't talk exactly the same, they didn't move exactly the same or whatever the fuck, nigga, Pac more so had a spirit more like Malcolm X than Martin Luther King or anybody else that you could possibly say that was like on that type of level. You feel me? Because Malcolm X wasn't taking that bullshit like most niggas are or will or have been. He was more so rebellious. Now, Pac comes, you feel me? I'm just going this off as far as I can remember, as far as I understand. It might be different down the line or whatever the case might have been somebody else. I'm just saying from my understanding, this is how I think it's going. You feel me? I'm 27 years old, you feel me? I wasn't born listening to Tupac. Tupac was something that I got into as I got older, my music matured, you feel me? Like when I around like 9, 10, 8, maybe 7, 8, I first started hearing Pac, and then from there, you feel me, that's when it really started. Okay, yeah, this nigga dope, you feel me? This is the one for us, you feel me? And then later on down the line, it was other individuals I listened to, but Pac was like, you feel me, the one that was definitely, you feel me, leading the way for our time frame. Well, but like my era before, like, you know, when I first, you know, came to this earth. And then, you feel me, after him, you feel me, I feel like on a spiritual level, Pac's spirit was into Nipsey Hussle, you feel me? And because Nipsey Hussle was more so building up and bringing together the black community. Even though when he first came out, he was rapping that gangster shit, you feel me? That's the same type of message I'm putting out with my music, because I want, that's who I want to get the attention from. I want to get the niggas that have came from similar backgrounds to me or indulging the street life type shit and utilize, you feel me, the soldier within you, you feel me, and let's unify and go together, because at the end of the day, when it's black on black, we killing our own soldiers, my nigga. We killing our own people, and we easily doing it. And we're consistently doing it versus focusing our attention in the other direction. We so quick to focus our attention in, you feel me, our own people. And then, you know, so as if you're looking at it from a spiritual level, let's say Malcolm went to Pac. Pac passed away. Pac went to Nipsey. You feel me? I ain't gonna say it's directly to the. I'm not too sure if it went to somebody else before it came to Nipsey. But from my understanding, I feel like Pac's spirit went through Nipsey. You feel me? And now when you think about it, Nipsey, you feel me? He was more so promoting like the same type of message as Pac was. You feel me? He was the of today's Tupac. You feel me? That's what he gets often compared to, is Tupac. You feel me? And if you listen to the music, it's somewhat similar. You feel me? Just, you know, it's coming from a more updated in tune, and you know, it's probably more so put together a little bit better than the way Pac did it. You feel me? I think Nipsey just had like a more fly way of putting shit together and making it sound like a little something more so than Pac did. Not to discredit Pac or knock anything he's done. That's just the way I look at it. That's just my own personal opinion. You feel me? But, you know, you can think what you want to, say what you want to. I don't give a fuck. But that shit written on my mind. I ain't here to make everybody happy. I ain't trying to make everybody mad. But if I do, oh, fucking well. I don't give a fuck. I'm not, that's not my goal, is to win everybody's opinion. Because from my understanding, Jesus was also hated, and he did nothing to offend or hurt anybody, and he was stoned to death. So that just goes to show you, it don't matter how nice or good to people you are, because the devil is working like a paisa, you understand me? And that motherfucker don't take no breaks or nothing. So anyways, I say all that to say this, you feel me? I feel like Pac's spirit was went to Nipsey, and now I don't know exactly what direction it's going in, but you feel me? On the song Only Fear of Death, I say all that to say this. The song Only Fear of Death, the niggas say, the only fear of death is coming back reincarnated. And could Nipsey be the reincarnation of Tupac? That's the only person I could see that could more so fill those shoes, you know what I'm saying? And you feel me? You can say what you want to, think what you want to, but I'm going to play the little part that, you know, that caught my attention. And this is the version of the song on YouTube, which I think that, you know what I'm saying, niggas need to get in tune with. You feel me? You see the views right now. Today is motherfucking April 4th, you feel me, 2019. This is the version of the song that I think it is, you feel me? And yes, I do live in my mama house. Yes, my TV's on the floor. No, I don't got a stand. And yes, I'm broke as fuck. But nigga, I don't give a fuck. I'm not trying to portray an image to motherfuckers that I don't have. You feel me? I am the nigga you see today. That's who I am. Yeah, nigga. And no, that's not a bonnet on my head, bitch. That's a place cap. Yeah, understand that. Now, this is the part that I'm talking about. Let me turn this motherfucker on, my bad, bro. Okay, check me out, though. Tell me if this is him or not, my nigga. Start from right here. Listen, the nigga says R.I.P. Nipsey. If I'm wrong, correct me. If not, run with me. Remember, John Doe underscore 4. Understand me, found this shit first. Ain't nobody else motherfucking came out here and did all this. So, nigga, if you hear anybody say anything about it, they got it from me. My baby mama tried to post this shit up, and as soon as I let her know, I had to let her know, delete that motherfucker, because, nigga, I found this, not you. Say this is dedicated to Nipsey, R.I.P. All right, I'll run it back for you, sucker, just so KT didn't hit me the first time. That's on all the blood. I don't give a fuck what nobody said. That nigga said Nipsey. That's on Faru. And if you don't believe me, that's fine, nigga. Shit, nigga. If you, hey, nigga, you believe what you want to, nigga. Potato, potato, tomato, tomato, whatever, nigga. The nigga said Nipsey, bro, nigga. That's my personal opinion. If he didn't say that, nigga, then shit, let me know. Go look up the lyrics. The nigga don't even say nothing that sounds or ends in that same type of syllable, nigga. So you hear me? This shit is realer than rap, my nigga. Don't believe anything. Believe what's right, my nigga. And shit, most of us don't even know what's right. So it's hard to believe what's anything going on. But yo, hey, you know what I'm saying? Give me your personal opinion. What y'all think? Like, dislike, subscribe, comment, whatever the fuck you do, do it and let me know what y'all think. John Doe underscore 4, bitch.